Hello there, this is Izzix with another episode of Crusader Kings 2 After the End Mod, where we are Lord Admiral Jalad the Just of the Redcoat Dominion, King of New England and various other places, Lord Protector of the Occultist Rites, and generally kind of a cool guy. Well, at least I'm more diplomatic than some of my previous characters. We have a recent Holy War modifier. We also have an Adventure Stewardship and Crest Revolts modifiers going on. And we had a request for a quick world tour of sorts. So let's, of course, start near the Redcoat Dominion. We are stretching from the Maritimes, Prince Edward Island, Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, all the way down the East Coast. And we've got Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut, parts of New York, most of New Jersey, Delaware, Maryland, most of Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, though real-life South Carolina extends all the way to this river here. Apparently this bit of territory over here, which is sort of northern Alabama, Tennessee sort of areas, because like Memphis is over here and the real life border is like goes right through here. We also have a little bit of territory down here in Florida, because some of our dudes have been going on adventures down there. What more? We got ourselves a little extension here through western Pennsylvania, northern Ohio, southern Michigan. And remember there was something going on with some of the guys over here, but apparently that didn't actually happen, or maybe it did and fell apart. Anyway, so that's our kingdom. We have the big blight of the Anabaptists sort of still in our midst. Though I think maybe today we'll be taking a chomp out of Allegheny, hopefully. There's also Hudsonia, which is a problematic place. I think, though, I'd like to say hello to somebody here. Somebody here who generally likes me. You seem to like me. Duke Lemuel the Just. You're not in any factions, right? Does not appear to be so. But, Duke Lemuel, I think I might want to do something cool with you. Alternatively, somebody else around here. Because my good friends, are part of New England, and I am the King of New England. And if I were to, like, form America, things like the Kingdom of New England and such would kind of cease to be. Now, I also have my kingdom, the Kingdom of the Maritimes, but you don't see this, the Kingdom of the Maritimes, in this particular setup here. This is Vermont. Redcoat Dominion is forfeit. Yeah. So, we only really need one kingdom title, Kingdom of Columbia, in order to, actually two of them. So, Kingdom of Gotham and Kingdom of Columbia are probably the ones we're going to go with. And so we're going to keep those two, but we're going to actually viceroyal out the rest of my kingdom titles for the moment. Kingdom of New Jersey. Such, but let's start off with the kingdom of New England. Actually, is this guy maybe better? Does he have any excess of guys? Not really, I guess. Anyway, so you seem pretty cool. You're going to become the Viceroyal of New England. Kingdom of New England. this is going. These things are all fit. Feudal dukes and kings subject opinions of you to minus two. That's okay. Yeah. You're now in charge of all this. Go have a happy time invasion of something here, I guess. you can see that the flags of New England and the flags of the Redcoat Dominion are very similar. Just like, yeah, I guess we're under British control. what else are we going to do? Also going to viceroyal up you the good old Vermont, because why not? There you go. So you are now double viceroyal, because this is Vermont here, yeah. so we're going to get this sorted out, and then we're going on tour. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten. I almost did. what else do we need? So we're going to keep Columbia and Gotham, but we're going to dump Jersey, I think? You? Maybe you. Guy in Beatamont. Yeah. You don't like me very much, though. I don't know, but this might make you happier, I guess? Let's grant you a viceroyalty of New Jersey. You are now a super guy. Viceroyal... What is your name here? Governor Leo of Jersey. Neat. Sweet. So I'm still Kingdom of Gotham and Columbia, but now we have viceroyalties all up to his house here. So, that's sorted out. We are much reduced on our vassals, of course, but that's fine. And now, instead of having to summon guys up from the far end of tomorrow, I'm just like, hey, you guys, give me 1,000 troops or something like that. Of course, this also means I have fewer troops to call upon, but actually, that is sort of one thing I should have been worrying more about. Eh, it should be fine. I need more drink. Oh. Don't worry, I'm not alcoholic. This is actually juice here. Why are you not underneath that? Oh, because this is my own dukedom, I guess. Maybe. Weird. Or maybe this is you're underneath something else? No, you're in New England. It's kind of weird. Oh, well. So. Let's start out up here. So up here, we got a whole bunch of small little counts and things like that who are a mix of brethren and old occultists. We got our own occultist sort of bleeding into this area, including this guy here. There's also some Angeline and some Ursuline sort of locals set up there. I don't think there's actually any Ursuline top-level rulers anymore. Makes the Ursuline Sea a little silly here. What else we got? We also got these guys here, which I think might be ceasing to be sometime in the near future. They're really trying to push the restoration of the full Maritimes. Got the Anabaptists over here. They are problematic, but they are not the end of the world. The dreaded Amish. They actually are pretty strong, so that's why I haven't really been churning through them too much. I've been focusing on more Confederate areas so I can restore America. There's the High Church areas here in Ontario and Michigan, who are sort of kind of at each other's throats or something. These guys are Thomasists. So they have a very diverse religious area, but they're the Thomasists all the way, apparently. I actually played, before I started my campaign, near a little campaign as a Thomasist in Michigan, Detroit. And actually did something kind of similar to this, so I guess this is sort of the default mode for the area. Oh, who would have thought? Got Aurora up here. We've got sort of the Norse pagan areas, which are slowly fading away. Sort of being a mix of Rest cultists here. Ohio is pretty much the biggest Rest cultist around, and they're sort of maintaining, mainly due to their, quote, alliance with me. So people aren't, I guess, interested in attacking them. Up north, we still got ourselves the... Where is it? Government types. Got the nomadic Toque guys up here. The Nessiana. Saskatchewans here. Wyoming and various other folks. So we're going to the Midwest now. We got the Christian homelands. The Neo-Gnostics and Catholics have sort of dominated this area. Iowa's the big one in the north. You got Comanche used to be the big one in the south, and as well as Jacinto. But these guys seem to be having some issues here. What is this actually about? Lower crown authority, huh? Good luck with that. But when they are repaired, they'll be pretty big here. You got the papacy hanging out in St. Louis here. They're annoying, but they're workable. wonder if they're going to holy war somebody at some point here. We got sort of the western Appalachian slope area, which is also kind of a mess. You know, mix of revelationists, charismatic... Catholics, what is this here, Thomasists, consumerists, all sort of mixing together in sort of a hodgepodge of little tiny countries. Some of them get a little bit bigger, like West Tennessee. What is he? He's an old occultist. Neat. Keep up the good work, guys. How the heck did you get over there? Oh, it's supposed to be an adventure at some point. Anyway, so we also got the Holy Columbian Confederacy, which we've taken, like, half of them. maybe like two-fifths, yeah. We got a little bit of here and these guys. We got something that's kind of amazing. We got the Caribbean Empire, which is Americanist, as far as the leadership goes. Yeah. Caribbean Empire. Yeah. The Americans have fled to the Caribbean. I guess maybe they got the start in Puerto Rico. I don't know. What do we got over here? King Alphys the Fat. Dr. Alphys the... Anyway, so, we've got sort of a mixed thing here, the central Christian lands here. Then we go and we'll get to Mexico in a moment. Go to the northwest now. We got sort of all the Cetics and Guyans and what is this here? Zuhi-Kigang. I have no idea how to pronounce that properly. They're sort of dominating the area. The Guyans, who used to sort of dominate this area, have been kind of pushed about, torn asunder, pushed down south a bit. Yes. But things are kind of a hodgepodge here. Who are these guys here? Umalata. Mal. Alright. Then we got Amazing California, who's been a pretty good success here. We got the revolts from these guys, and then we have the actual empire itself. There we go. Celestial Emperor Anthony. the Celestial Empire of California starts as a figurehead emperor. They've managed to go well beyond that at this point, so that's good on them. Though Grand San Francisco and the other aesthetic type places here are still sort of hanging out, not being part of their Grand Empire. So, moving to south now, we got the Arixo, who is a Thomasist. No, this is not a Thomasist. This is Christian, actually. They've been replacing the Thomasists here, invading. Got some Thomasists up here, but Taos. On sort of the Colorado region here. Pueblo, Wyoming. Taking over Denver. Oh my! Baja is pretty big. They're a kingdom of sorts. A delicious kingdom guy who is sitting on these sort of. Prefix. Interesting. Oh. But he's the biggest king around, yo. And I'm gonna try to not burp too much here. They're also Cetic type folks, so they're nominally aligned with California as far as religion and culture goes. Going down to Mexico here. Northern Mexico is sort of divided up. This is all sort of the Sagro Corazon sort of faith, which gives like little, where is it here? Santa Mort and the wrestler guy and like the Virgin Mary sort of thing going on. Sierra Madre is pretty big in the northern bits here, but a lot of smaller sort of mid-sized kingdoms here and duchies and things like that. Then we got the big one in southern Mexico, which is actually Mexico. They are kind of kicking ass and dominating the region, which is good for them. Going a little bit further south until the end of our tour, we got all these folks down here, which are of the Uamachi faith, and well as Neo Mayans and other various sort of things going on here. They're more divided up. Guatemala experienced recently-ish, a bit of an adventure where they had some revolters, and then Brazil declared war on the revolters for their big grand invasion, and because the revolt ended, their invasion was invalid. So Brazil might have some armies down here. And no one to invade. So silly. They really should have a thing that will discourage that sort of activity. Yeah. Attack the kingdom, not the revolter. Anyway, getting on to the actual episode now. Now that we've kind of given an update of what's going on in the world. We want to move forward here. Actually, because this is the territory of Vermont is primary title. Territory of Vermont. Yeah, because I'm starting up a new recording today. This morning, I actually had to wait a bit for the mowers and such to get their stuff done, because I live in an apartment complex, and so they kind of do that. It's Governor Lemuel the Just, Governor of Vermont and New England beyond. I guess it's kind of apt, because he is based in Vermont here. But maybe this will give him the courage to go attack Hudsonia here. Lynchburg is a big curve of cultist faith. Is that you down here? Country religion, yes. Has been released. Cruel's dungeon, neat. Hmm. What was this? Montpelier from Vectron Phytown. Oh no! Why'd he do that? Hmm. Maybe because he was a jerk. Wanted more territory for himself. And now that he's a king, he has more people to worry about? Hmm. Declared want holy war for... Neat. Commodore, your islands are going to be... I guess... done with here? Is that your full thing there? So, guess he's going to be in charge of this soon. Just the sort of thing I've been kind of hoping that would happen. Also, someone in the comments the other day, sorry for getting your exact username right now, suggested I should do more of this. I'm like, you know, really, I really should. I've been sort of trying to mean to do that. Because they've had good success with these guys expanding about. And sort of have sub-bullies push around other folks as I sort of be the big bully here. Hmm. How's our money? Our money's fine, I think it won't. We haven't been really building much lately. Been more trying to rebuild our retinues and such like that. Speaking of... it's gone up again. Let's see about getting more... you guys. And... yeah... wait a little bit more. It'll be good to go for our glorious, glorious adventures fighting the Alleghenians. Now, I think I'll use my next Holy War, actually, to push around these guys, because they got a fairly big duchy here, West Susquehanna, because there's also coal land here, but this will be pretty much like half their territory. Well, almost half, not quite. Then I can county war bits here off of them if I wish. And, what's this? Hmm. This is a formal declaration of war. High Chairman, Executive Director of the Old Dominion. Do you have any idea what you're doing here, man? Do you have any idea? I mean, really? Really, guy? Ugh. I have to go fight the Old Dominion. Hey, Confederates, could you go kill him or something? So, I guess we're at war now. Not a war I would have liked to have started off with, but yeah, we'll see about rolling them here. You know, like, yes. Let's come help out. So everyone's like, gather everybody up in Danville. We'll have a big enough force to basically counteract them entirely. And yeah. And you as well. Nice big fighting force. I suspect if we just crush them enough, they'll probably give up and go home. But you never know. You never know. Alright, you guys as well. And maybe some of my own forces. Just to sort of round her out. I'm going to keep my retinues actually up here for the time being. Let our vassals take care of this war, because they should be not too upset, because this is a defensive war and all that. Like, AI, are you stupid? I mean, really. My half-brother X-Death is requesting people to travel, foreign merchants and such. I don't have really the money to give you extra gold. Yeah, bring glory to our name. Go visit the queen. Here she's friendly, I guess. Count down to the end. After the end. Galax, very nice. Just sort of rolled right over them. So you're going to have to face our death stacks here before you get anywhere interesting, Mr. Consumerist. You're trying to consume our land. This is unacceptable. Neat. Occultism spreads wild. Left, right, and center. And you decided to stick around here in the hills. That's fine. We can deal with you down there, sir. Mankind is unlovable. No more charity. I'm no longer charitable. I guess because as consumers are like, we're greedy. I'm like, but we're like, I don't know, we're not consumers, so I guess we're communists? No, that doesn't quite make sense. we're cultists, that's what we are. I guess maybe charity doesn't really sort of fit with that mold. Seems to take a while to get up from Galax Danville here. Guess it is crossing the Appalachian Mountains. Land of attrition. The hidden valleys. Places far remote. Like this bit of, West Virginia and such. Alright, we are almost assembled. Then we'll go in and swing through and crush them! Siege of New Glasgow. That's annoying. You guys are still fighting there? Governor Diggory of the Sword of the Spirits. Alright, so this guy's pretty good, probably. I guess I could be a little more discerning with my generals here, but this guy's Ezekiel's pretty awesome, actually. Let's get Ezekiel on the case here. And I guess Palador Denton Lambert. Experimentality. It's a very... troops. Yeah, Palador's probably a better option, not a gooder option. What am I? What am I saying? What sort of nonsense am I speaking? It's like, yes, the Red Coat Dominion was distracted by nothing. So obviously it's time to invade. Gosh, crazy consumerists. I really should just go end them. Gatisse is pregnant. Excellent. Let's have some more babies. Reports of the population. Not quite as great as cultist faith. Very nice. We are trying to bring fear to Cape Fear, though. The fear of the deep ones. As they crawl out of the oceans. Say hello. Survived to the loot and pillage. Oh, come on, lady. Hosts and things like that. Come on. Stop it, guys. What is this here? Arranged marriage between Lemuel the Just, governor of Vermont and New England, and my half-sister and my kinsman. A little squeaky, but okay. She does have lover's pox, so watch out for that. She's also known to sleep around, so have fun. You'll get a baby eventually. Just might not be yours. Don't worry about it. Yeah. So let's crush them. In the hills, in the mountains, and various other places. Let's come to your demands, back to the language. Wisdom. Yes, I am a wise guy. Inherited Duchy of Dalmare and other titles from Duke Nukem and Norman the Cruel. Yeah. Got a council position. A marshal. Phineas. Yeah, we'll do you. Yeah, we'll get you to train some troops up here. Have fun. Our capital of Boston. Core of my empire. Okay, that's cool. Cool thing. And we are doing well on crushing their spirits. Hooray! Yeah, very nice. Very nice. And most of their army is now destroyed. Let's go to docks and see if we can finish them off. And then we'll go home. That's one of the reasons I didn't want to bring my retinues down this way. Is that I'll... I kind of like to have them up north so I can use them to fight the Anabaptists. Grand Strand. Very nice. Cultism is running wild! Your agents have discovered there's a risk of visiting American soldier sites. Throw him in the dungeon. Excellent. So now, let's ransom him for 70 gold. Ho ho! You would have to pay eventually, sir. Why do you think you could do it without? You silly, silly man. I'm released. Very good. You have a certain level of justice here. Might not be certain, but your level of justice is insufficient. Let's go split these guys up. Put the larger stack going this way. You and... Yeah, you. You guys will sit around here, because if we need to siege something, we can. This way. It's like, gosh darn it, consumerists. You had one job. One job only, and that's to die. This powerful Roman tells him to make a pilgrimage. So, King Nolson the Bold, Secretary of Defense of the Caribbean Empire, King of Yucatan. Well, I guess I could throw him in the dungeon. So, I could kill him, or I could ransom him for 250 gold. Yoink. Silly Americanists. Just have to be asked nicely and you're going to be cool. Some of the random ladies we picked up over the years are starting to die in our prison. Awkward. King Nolson. Very cool. Guess it's this occasional imprisoning thing that gets people sort of worried. I'm a very, very magmatic Lord Admiral, after all. They would just, you know, either pay up or say nice things about me. I'm cool. Ah, excellent. Dunlap. I don't really care about this war, so I'm okay with a white peace, though getting much money off you could be useful. Question is this going to be worth my time? Yeah, might be. Guess probably just getting one or two sieges would be done. Good. So let's go ahead and wait on those guys. Meanwhile, let's see about adding more to my retinues. Looks like we're going to need more heavy guys. Let's go and grab those. Meanwhile, we can grab a few more of these guys so we can get our archers nice and even. And we're going to grab some more cavalry. Cavalry cavalcade. Yes. And when we get enough gold, we'll take another one then. Because those are nice guys to have on hand here. Oh, look at this. What's he doing here? He summoned up some sort of mercenaries, looks like. Going right to Nox. Well, that might not be the smartest move we could do. Let's go kill more face here. don't know what you're playing at, guy. I should just ruin your day and take your kingdom title. So, is this guy... Yeah, he's directly under you. You're directly under you. Just encourage... We're in a cast by... Brigands! Well, I'll get the governor happy, and the mayor will be less so. But that's okay. I kind of don't care which one gets more pissed at me. Either one works. Alright, let's go crush them. Crush them! We outnumber them, we are superior in all sorts of different fashions. Because we are occultists and they are consumerists. So they have to go buy their armies. I'm just like, I summon them up for the dark places in the universe. And they scream the names of men. And terror fills their hearts. Jeanette. Now let's go with... What's a good lady's name? No. Yes, no. No. Why can't I think of a good one right now? Victoria. Yes, after the Queen. Victoria the 71st. excellent. I am now more ambitious. So, what am I going to do here? Amass wealth. Okay. part of the majority of the population has been converted to the cult's faith. Excellent. Let's do that more. I was giving you exchange. Oh, sweet. Yoink. I will take your money, and I will have good things happen with it. I demand this. Gonna try to reinforce here. These guys are actually pretty badass. Murder is dragged before you. His wife, gentlemen, which is small, but hut they called home. Well, last time there was some sort of crazy murder, so we're gonna set him free this time. As more and more people seek audience at your court, you have come to realize that there's much to do when it comes to the administration realm. You must work harder, it's diligent, it gives me bonuses up the wazoo. I like that. It means I can have more territory that's I call my own. Excellent. And now we're 100%. You just waste a whole lot of money and men for nothing. Give me a pile of money, guy. Excellent. I have won the day. And let's put these guys away. Let's summon up a few more retinues. Boink. Extra cavalry. I guess I could also... I know this isn't going to help my efforts to get up to the maximum monies I want for my ambition here, but, you know. So we got a whole pile of dudes over here. I'm actually going to set these guys aside so they can recover. Become huge and large. And at the start of the month... At the start of the month, we're going to be all like, Hey, you. King Adolfred the Holy. I don't think you're really all that holy now to think about it. You better bring in your buddy King of Hudsonia on this here, potentially. But I think I could take both, yes. I think I could. It's going to give me a hard-fought battle of wits and dynamic adventures and such. But I think we're going to be able to win the day. Yes. Because I would like to holy war up in his house. And that. Niagara, nope. That, nope. West Susquehanna. Yeah. So. King Aldefrid, the so-called holy. We stand at odds. I'm declaring war. Ba-dam, bam, bam. Bum, 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 bum. And with this, I am going to summon up pretty much everybody, really. Why everybody? Because these guys can punch pretty hard. Actually, you put you down. I'm actually going to summon you up over here. Do be careful with these guys, so we're gonna get these fellows going cool places. We'll send them through the old Dominion territories here. Or not. Guess that's when Selena's here. And we'll get them set up here. As for you guys, hey, you guys. Now we're just reeling a little bit from the crazy old Dominion's experimentation there, but we'll get things set up in Trenton, looks like. You guys, gotta get you guys a little bit further away from some of the action points here. You can actually put you away, so we're going to summon you up over here. Hooray! We just teleported these guys a few hundred miles, it's all good. So everyone who's not moving over here, come over to Manhattan, please. As for you guys, no, not there. We'll summon you up over here. Same deal. Teleporting armies. They're delightful. We also have some other more far-flung guys, I think. Actually, no, these are all part of the kingdom up here. Kingdom of the Redcoat Dominion. So, Anabaptist crazy people. You have a lot of troops. We have to crush them. Crush them a lot. And hopefully we'll not be attacked too early here. We're gonna... Actually, let's move these guys back to Manhattan. It's a more defensible location. The rest of these guys will be coming on to various spots here. So not you. Not you. Actually, yeah. Okay, we'll get them a little bit further away. I feel excited, guys. I feel excited. Technology? Let's tech up. Tech. Some sort of construction, looks like. Maybe some keeping here. Boink. And we'll get the construction up, just to make it cheaper. Means I should probably get to building some more stuff over here in Boston. Yeah, we've got plenty of room. So, Hudsonia is also involved now. Neat. So that means we got ourselves a real throwdown here. But I think that's going to be for next episode. teasing I am. And because my voice is actually a little and I need to take a little bit of a break, I might not record this episode until tomorrow, so we'll have to see what happens then. So, thank you all for joining me for another episode of Crusader Kings 2 After the End Mod. With me, Isix, as we are red-coating it up in the dominion of Greater New England, East Coast, Future America, once again. The kingdom that has come and gone. And we got a nice big army which to crush them with. It's gonna be a bit of an adventure, guys. So, till next, everybody. Toodles. Woohoo!